Robin Williams is Bill Monroe, the harried father of a typical new millennium American family in Barry Sonnenfeld's comedy, RV. Disrespected by his teenage daughter, ignored by his pre-teenage son, and lovingly tolerated by his wife, Bill seeks to adjust matters by arranging to take the family on a vacation to Hawaii. But as he's about to leave, his boss orders him to an important conference halfway across America. Bill tries to kill two birds with one stone by renting an RV and driving to the business meeting with his family in tow, keeping from them the purpose of his change of vacation plans. But what does Bill know about the hazards of RV living? He'll soon find out, and so will you.
Bill was blown right out of that tree, and right before he hit the ground, from out of nowhere, comes this queen-size Simmons mattress, slides right under him and cushions his fall.
Saved his life. Plus, we needed the mattress.
I have a bad back.
So, you folks want to join us for breakfast?
We
ate. Mr. Monroe, I was just telling Earl Newt about that neat laptop you were using.
When were you using a laptop?
At work, all the time. I was just telling him
that... When did he see you using one?
You know, we'd love to join you for breakfast.
Somebody's right.
Welcome to my world.
Come on. Why don't you guys go on in and get that table? We'll be right there. All right, come on, kids.
We're ditching them?
Absolutely.
Well, Richard, here we go, and I get the first words this
Please.
Time. This film is just a horror. It's got toilet humor, other crude humor, sexual innuendos for kids. It is on a par with the Chevy Chase family vacation film.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
No.
And why Robin Williams would do something like this, and why they would not use his talent, only in one spot here do they use his talent, but there are so many slapstick gags, and as I said, toilet humor gags. I mean, this is my worst film of the year.
Okay, let me counter this first off by saying by the preamble that I don't think it's what you laugh at that makes you a moron. It's often what you cry at. I thought Sonnenfeld's use of Barry Sonnenfeld, the director, was the cinematographer on Raising Arizona. I thought his use of widescreen was very adroit. It kind of reminded me of old Frank Tashlin movies at times. I think there was a sense of ugliness in this that really kind of sharpened the comedy by the fact that the women folk in here, between Cheryl Hines, who's been like so eviscerating on Curb Your Enthusiasm, the Larry David show, as the wife, by Jojo Levesque as the very evil teenager. This is kind of peekaboo haircut, this one cocked black eyebrow and this gunslinger's eye underneath it, a real worst case scenario of a 15-year-old. I was laughing. When it comes to the toilet humor, I have to realize that comedy audiences are formed of coalitions like political parties. And there's some people that just need that low-end stuff that just bores me and disgusts me. But I'll put up with it so I can get the funnier parts later on. The deadpan reactions, the flicker of distaste,
All I can say for the words you just said, the word forensic, which now usually applies to dead bodies, but used to debating, you have just done it a wonders
well, thank
in
you.
Both meanings.
Well, thank you. No, I think it was funny. I think it's a hit people don't have to feel sorry about. I think compared to Meet the Parents, which was also full of toilet humor, which was also, but had no pizzazz to it at all. I mean, it didn't have any kind of distance, and it didn't really get into the fact that people are like working themselves, the stuff you were talking about earlier, people are working themselves in early graves in the same way that Williams is doing, like staying up all night on his miserable laptop, blind to the beauties of this country, trying to find a signal for his cell phone.